Good morning, and welcome to the worship and praise of God at United Church of Sun City on this Sunday morning. I am Reverend Brady Abel. It is wonderful to see each and every one of you here this Sunday morning. As we gather today, like every Sunday, we join our voices and declare together that God is good.
All the time.
Amen. Friends, we do want to keep in prayer all those listed in the bulletin. We add to that this morning special prayers for our church member Chris Clausen, whose sister died unexpectedly this week after a fall, her sister Jan. And then on top of everything, Chris's dog died as well. So prayers, Chris, for you. Tomorrow is September 11th, and as we remember the events of 9/11, 22 years ago, we think of all the victims, their families. We give thanks for the police and the firefighters working so hard that day and their sacrifices. We lift up our service men and women who fought in the wars following the events of 9/11, those who died, their families, and those who still serve this nation today. And as always, we pray for peace, not only in this land, but worldwide. We add our prayers to prayers from all around the world for the people of Morocco after the devastating earthquake there on Friday. As I'm sure you've heard, the death toll is in the thousands, with many more injured. So we pray for everybody involved and for all the rescue workers and their efforts as well. And as always, we pray for all joys and concerns that go unannounced this day. Please make note that on Sunday, September 17th, that would be next Sunday, after worship, we will have a new member class. We will meet right up here for 15 or 20 minutes. If you're interested in joining United Church, please plan to stay for that meeting. Then on Sunday, September 24th, we will welcome the new members into the life of our congregation here at United Church. It's always an exciting time whenever we can welcome new members to United Church. Bears. I wrote in the newsletter about this prayer bear that sits right here on the pulpit. Briefly, this bear was given to me at my dad's memorial service at the church where I grew up in southwest Iowa. They had received it from a church in northern Iowa, and they don't know how they received it, but they did. So they shared it with me to bring it back here. We were supposed to keep it for a while and then share it with another church. However, since I got it at my dad's memorial service, I cannot stand to give it away. So some of us were talking, and we decided we would start a Bless a Bear to Share campaign. Now, those of you sitting over here, you can't see this, but take a look after worship, if you would. We have a table set up, and we are going to collect stuffed bears, new or gently used, no more than 12 inches high, and we will share those bears after they have been blessed by us right here with the worship and praise of God. One place that we will share the bears is through our Angel Tree ministry to Luke Air Force Base this Christmas, when we share gifts with the children at Luke. We will also share a bear with another church. So if you would like to donate a bear, bring it by the end of October, but this bear will be staying right here. That's our bear. Alan, how about a choir invitation?
Absolutely. You're all invited to join choir. We start next Sunday, the 17th, with just a rehearsal. We don't sing for the public yet, but if you're new to church, go through this double doors back here by Pastor Brady's office, and you'll see the music room. Every Sunday we'll meet 8:40 till 9:40, so then you just walk in to church by 10 o'clock. So I'd say give it a try. Talk someone into it. I'll try it if you'll try it, and we're already preparing for our Christmas Cantata, December 17th. Also, 2 weeks from today, on the 24th, there will be a huge choir and a huge concert up here at 3 p.m., the Sounds of the Southwest Singers. Tell your family and neighbors about that. 3 p.m., wonderful variety concert, followed by, of course, free ice cream sundaes. Yay. So put that on your calendar. Thanks.
Thank you, Alan. Lots of good stuff coming up. And I suppose this is the point when I should say congratulations to the Detroit Lions. Yes? And let's move on quickly. As we do, let us turn and greet one another with our smiles and our waves. Good morning, one and all. And now let us join together in this moment of silence as we center our hearts, minds, and souls on the worship and praise of God.
Up his sleeve, he ain't just putting on the Ritz.
Our God is an awesome God.
There is thunder in his footsteps and lightning in his fist.
Our God is an awesome God.
And the Lord wasn't joking when he kicked him out of Eden. It wasn't for no reason that he shed his blood.
His return is very close, and so you better be believing that
our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God.
When the sky was starless in the void of the night,
our God is an awesome God.
He spoke into the darkness and created the light.
Our God is an awesome God.
Judgment and wrath he poured out on Sodom. The mercy and the grace he gave us at the cross.
I hope that we have not too quickly forgotten that our God
is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God.
I invite all who are able to rise as we join together in our unison prayer. Please join with me. Here we are, Lord, more than two or three, gathering intentionally in your name with you in our midst to worship you. We thank you once again for your living example of how we can live our lives. Yes, there can be tough times. You know that better than all of us. Still, with love as our guide, we watch the challenges disappear, and we feel your assurance take hold an embrace that lasts for eternity. With grateful hearts we pray. Amen. And let us sing together our opening hymn, "Lead On, O King Eternal."
Lead on, O King Eternal, the day of march has come. Henceforth in fields of conquest, thy tent shall be our home. Through days of preparation, thy grace has made us strong. And now, O King Eternal, we lift our battle song. Lead on, O King Eternal, till sin's war shall cease, and holiness shall whisper the sweet amen of peace. For not with swords loud clashing, nor rolling stirring drums, with deeds of love and mercy, the heavenly kingdom comes. Lead on, O King Eternal, we follow not with fears, for gladness breaks like morning wherever thy face appears. Thy cross is lifted o'er us, we journey in its light. The crown awaits the conquest, lead on, O God of might.
You may be seated. We come now to this time of prayer, beginning with silent prayer. Let us pray. God of all people, gathered here to worship you, we hear your call again to turn away from the behaviors geared for our own self-promotion and instead seek to live in ways that help us connect to others. You know it's easy for people to walk away from hurtful relationships and to talk behind other people's backs rather than to their faces. That's not your way. You call us to love others as deeply as we are loved by you. You show us how to deal honorably with one another, even those and especially those who have hurt or offended us. You show us how to work through our disagreements with love and integrity, and in doing so, to serve as an example for others, just as you serve as an example for us. As your followers, we pray for it to be so. Now, Lord, we ask that you hear us as we join our voices, continuing to pray with the words we have been taught to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.